2.5 feet of water still, so feeding fish should be here, especially off that grass. Although there's a hell of a lot more current than usual. And this is about where I caught that big bass. Hey, you know, I was reading an article about lure prices, and if it wasn't for the theft, I said if it wasn't for, oh, for a second I thought it was a walleye. If it wasn't for theft, it would be a hell of a lot cheaper.
Hey, slow down, fella.
It was that much cheaper?
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's just, you know, that's why, you know, unless they keep them off of, this guy was caught. Yeah, thievery. It would be like a lot cheaper, but they got to recover all the losses, you know. That guy didn't even feel like a fish; he was so little.
You want to fish this backwater or what?
We'll go back a little ways. I mean, it's. I got a feeling though, because of the temperature drop overnight, it isn't likely to be that great. The northerns could be in here though, so
yeah, anything could be back here. That's what I'm saying. Bass.
I would think, though, that, yeah, I mean, yeah, some guy wrote on one of those message boards, he goes, are the bluegills still spawning at the Des Plaines Conservation Area?
What?
Do they spawn twice or something?
Bluegills will spawn multiple times.
Okay, that's what he was saying, because he said he saw them, you know, or it's other beds. Really, multiple times. That's pretty cool.
Well, I forgot to get the top of the tree.
Oh, we're in 6.5 feet of water.
Mm-hmm.
Right, there's no depth to it. Everything. Flat as a pancake on the bottom here.
Mm-hmm.
9.6 feet. 10 feet of water here.
Got one.
All right. He's coming right at us. Look at this. I got a reel, man. He was coming right. Holy shit, Tim.
All right.
I think it's a largemouth. I don't know.
It's a
large. There you go.
I don't have much can out.
I don't need a picture of the mirror, though. Got a mirror there.
Good, it looks like.
Like super good. Gonna be tough to get this out of here. It's not fresh. Lure yourself. No. Oh, the lure's gone. You know what he did?
He
busted the hook, I think.
Oh,
oh no, he's free. He's nice though, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Shook it himself. He was barely hooked, but I mean, the hook literally went through twice.
Mm-hmm.
And he shook it in the net. Yeah. Thank goodness it was in the net. Yeah, that's not the only thing I could think of what would be in here. If, you know, the colder temperatures and everything. And he hit that on this little number 7.
Mm-hmm.
He was on video anyway.
What's the water temp?
63. So it's still not cold. Yeah. And anything could be in here, but the main river was a few degrees warmer.
Oh,
than I'll tell you one thing, water clarity's got to be good enough for him to see this little thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't even cast near that. He was probably in that underneath the leaf pile there. You know?
Yeah, well, water, the clarity is a lot. It's a lot more clear back here in the cap water.
I'm just glad he hit it lightly because he could have snapped this thing off. I really like this muddler pattern, though, you know, because look on the back, that little chartreuse.
Mm-hmm.
There's that little bit of chartreuse at the very back that adds, you know, a little more flash to it, and it looks natural except for that, obviously.